Lansing. I'm the curator at the Florence Griswold Museum in Old Lyme, Connecticut, where I'm standing in our exhibition, P.S. Letters from the Lyme Art Colony. We're delighted to feature in this exhibition a work that we've recently added to our collection by the American Impressionist Childe Hassam. He was an artist who started coming to Florence Griswold's boarding house in 1903, and one of the things that he really liked to do here was to paint outdoors. This is a painting, Apple Blossoms Old Lyme, Apple Trees in Bloom Old Lyme, that he did in 1904, the second year that he was visiting, and it shows his studio in the background. We're lucky enough to have a photograph of the artist painting this work, where you can see him with his brushes in his hand, this panel on his easel, and then the very ramshackle building that was his special studio right behind him with beautiful apple trees in front. This is a letter that he wrote to Florence Griswold in the spring of 1905, hoping that he would be able to come back and get this studio again. It was a place where he loved to step outside and look for subjects to paint. And what's interesting about this letter is that he says to Florence that he had wanted to come back to town when the first buds and blossoms were coming out. So he knew specifically that he wanted to come back so that he could see a sight like the one in his painting from the spring before. He specifically asks about his studio and her making a place for him and his wife in the house. And what's interesting about this letter as well is that there's a real similarity between the way the artist writes, his handwriting, and his touches with the brush and the painting. He writes with very small strokes of his pen. It's a little bit hard to read. Lots of little up and down marks. And if you look at the painting closely, you can see that there's a real similarity between his handwriting and the impressionist technique of painting. The artist used a lot of small individual strokes of paint to create this landscape. And so there's a real harmony between his letter, his handwriting, and his work of art. That's a concept that we're exploring in this exhibition, P.S. Letters from the Lyme Art Colony, which is on view through May 6th.